Today, I'm gonna answer a big question. What is generative AI? And as always, you know I've got the definition. Generative AI is a type of artificial intelligence that uses data to create new content, whether it's text, images, video, or audio. All you need to do is ask it for what you want. Simple, right? So, for example, you can ask generative AI to help you write a follow-up email to a client, to design a storyboard for your next marketing video, or create your own recipe for pizza-flavored ice cream. Now, before I go into more generative AI stuff, I need to talk about what came before it, and that was predictive AI. Predictive AI is another type of artificial intelligence that uses existing data to provide suggestions, insights, and intelligent predictions. It basically analyzes data, identifies patterns in that data, and then gives you useful suggestions. Now, I know what you're thinking. Brian, buddy, why are you talking about predictive AI in a video all about generative AI? Well, generative AI and predictive AI go hand in hand. And let me give you an example. Say you want to send an email to your loyalty members about a new sale on boots. Predictive AI can help by telling you the best time of day to send the email based on the performance of previous emails. And then generative AI can help you by suggesting subject lines, what the email will say, and even what visuals to include. Now, when you're using generative AI, there should always be a human in control making the final decisions, otherwise known as the human in the loop approach. AI's role is to augment humans, or in other words, make what we do better. You, AKA the human, are the head chef, and the AI is your sous chef. It's really the best way to get the outcome that you want, make sure it's done ethically, and build trust with your customers. All right, now for the techie part here. How does generative AI work? Well, there are a few different ways to develop generative AI models. One of the most popular ways is by using pre-trained large language models, or LLMs, to create new content from text-based prompts. LLMs use machine learning techniques and massive amounts of data sets to fuel an AI. And these algorithms make it possible for AI to take in enormous amounts of information, continuously train itself, and understand the relationships between data so it can generate content. Okay, now let's go a layer deeper here. There are two types of deep learning models LLMs use: generative adversarial networks, or GANs, and transformers. So let's talk about transformers. And sorry, no Autobots versus Decepticons here, even though I was really hoping for that. But these transformers create outputs based on sequential data like sentences or paragraphs rather than individual data points. And this approach helps the model efficiently process context and is used to generate or translate text. Ever heard of the term GPT? Yeah, that stands for Generative Pre-trained Transformer. And GPT is the transformer model used to create chatbots for the public to use, which is exactly what ChatGPT is. While GANs and transformers are some of the most popular generative AI models, there are others too. But we don't need to get into all that. We're sticking to the basics here. So let's move on to how generative AI can help make your work better and faster and easier. Businesses of any size can use AI technology to increase productivity, reduce costs, and personalize experiences for every customer. But companies aren't just using AI to achieve these goals. They're combining the powers of AI and what's called CRM. Not sure what CRM is? Well, that stands for Customer Relationship Management. It's basically a technology that helps you manage all your company's relationships and interactions with customers in one place. That way, all your teams, so we're talking sales, service, marketing, and everyone else, can streamline their data, work efficiently, and get a complete view of customers. Now, it would be impossible to have an episode of Salesforce Explained without talking a little bit more about Salesforce, because we are crushing the artificial intelligence slash CRM game. Trust me on that. I mean, I am a trailblazer after all. You know you want this. So let me give you a few examples of how Salesforce's CRM solutions and its generative AI called Salesforce Einstein can help you with sales, service, and marketing. For starters, sellers can sell faster. They can use generative AI like Einstein to write personalized emails to prospects, to create summaries of sales calls, and to get predictions or suggestions that will help them seal the deal. Now, in the customer service field, generative AI can help reps and agents deliver more personalized experiences and increase productivity. If a customer has questions about a product they purchased, the agent can ask Einstein for relevant information during the conversation. And that helps them solve the issue faster and gets the customers the answers that they need instantly. Then, Einstein can automatically summarize the case resolution and create a knowledge article for other agents and even customers to reference in the future. Now, for marketers, AI can see what worked best in a previous marketing campaign, and then it can use those insights to create a strategy and generate email content. But wait, it gets even cooler here. AI can also help marketers easily build personalized customer journeys and tailor messages to each customer. This whole generative AI thing couldn't possibly get any cooler, right? Well, brace yourself here, okay? I'm holding on to you. Salesforce introduced the Einstein One platform to help you safely connect any data and use AI in all your Salesforce apps and workflows. The Einstein One platform could be its own episode. In fact, we've done some great videos on that already that I'm gonna link in the description below, but here's what you need to know. Since it's built on what's called the Salesforce Metadata Framework, the data tools and AI features in the Einstein One platform are readily available in any Salesforce product that you use. Think of the metadata framework as the bridge that connects data between all those different apps. So what does that mean for your bottom line? Well, with the Einstein One platform, you can take productivity to completely new heights, significantly reduce costs, and give customers the best experiences you ever thought were possible. And really the best part of all this is that you can do it quickly and safely. Did you catch that safely part, right? Well, Salesforce knows that generative AI will bring so many opportunities and so many risks. That's why Salesforce created the Einstein Trust Layer, and this is a secure AI architecture built right into the Einstein One platform. It allows you to benefit from generative AI while following your company's data privacy and security standards, and it can help you catch potential problems before they happen. Okay, that is it for this episode of Salesforce Explained. If you want to learn more about our friend Einstein and Salesforce's AI solutions, click the link on your screen. We'll also put more resources for you in the description. Thanks so much for watching, and we'll see you next time.